They're not so much on their phone when you're sitting talking to them. They're present, but their mind is in their past or worry about future. The younger generations, they got hit by cell phones and distraction. So they have a very hard time being here, being present with you. So their attention, putting their attention, although they're not regimented, so their mind is still not so brainwashed, so it's easier to deviate them on the right track, but now they have this issue of not being able to concentrate because they're distracted. They're everywhere but here. So both generations suffering from the same thing in different ways. So I just want to go over this one more time before I move into the next thing. I want to make sure you get this. Let me make it very clear, okay? So I'm going to, just in case you jumped in, you're new, you just came, and you weren't listening, or you were distracted with your cat or dog or your partner or your phone rang or whatever happened, okay? Or you had to go to the bathroom or you had to go to the kitchen to pick up some fruits or water. Let me go over it one more time. I want to make sure you understand this because it's important for you that you get it. Meditation is not an action. So whenever I come and sit down and I say, okay, I'm gonna sit there and meditate, I'm not saying it's a bad thing. I'm not saying don't do it. Doing this is a lot better than being in front of TV listening to CNN and getting filled up with a lot of fear and blah, blah, blah. But let's be clear about and understand and get the big picture. Meditation is not an action. Meditation is not something you do. Meditation is something that will happen to you. It's a natural occurrence. Hold on to this thought. While you're digesting this, I need to get my Instagram running again because last week I didn't have connection, so I couldn't do it. All right, so sure. Just 1 second. Forgive me. Just be patient with me. It's a one-man show. Okay, good. So we can get the Insta again going. Cool. We got that. So meditation is not an action. Meditation is not something you do. Meditation is something that happens naturally. It's an occurrence that happens. And it happens to everybody on this planet. Everybody at certain point are being meditative about what they do or what they don't do. A manipulated meditation is not really have no value. When we try to manipulate it, to force it to happen, it's as absolutely of no value to you. So the work we're doing, all this jumping jacks, if we're doing any kind of active meditations, if it's a laughing meditation, crying meditation, it requires action. If we're just, I don't know, doing Kriya yoga, you got one finger here, one finger there, and you have to breathe from here and breathe from there. Or you do TM, transcendental meditation, or whatever meditation you do in the world, I don't care what that is. All of them are preparing you You're tuning your instruments in order to do the concert. So we're doing this kind of meditation. We're doing the practice so we can be present and one in daily life and be meditative, to have the big vision, to not being reactive, not showing reaction to events, actually being able to step back and use your wisdom and intelligence before you react, before you say something, before you get angry. So meditation comes into your daily life. If your car breaks down on a intersection, all of a sudden the car is not starting, you don't panic and scream and yell and cry and not to what it is. You stay centered because you learn how to be meditative. So you're centered, you take a deep breath, you're looking at your options. Okay, the car is stopped. There's 50 different cars around me. Everyone's honking their horn. They're angry, they're upset because my car broke down. You get out of your car, very calm, very cool. Very cool, very collected. You get out of your car, you pull the hood up, you take a look. Okay, you can't fix it. You look around, you ask a couple of strong guys to help you to push the car, to pull the car on the corner of the street so you can call tow truck or mechanic to come and help you. But you're not doing it out of panic because you're practicing, you're meditative. You have learned how to do things in life meditatively. Now you're in meditation. You understand? You have brought, otherwise, what good does it do? You sit there and you're quiet and you're in meditation for 1 hour. You're one with God. Great, fantastic. But the moment you turn on the TV and they say, oh, there's going to be mandatory vaccination, or there is a draft and you have to go to war, you know, we're going to send you all to war or whatever, and you're panic and you're high blood pressure and you have to take your cholesterol pills and you're da da da, and you're making phone calls and you're crying. Well, you were just one with God. What happened to that? Or you just came from Bali, or you just came from India, you were with your guru, and you were in this such a high space, and as soon as you entered, and you came back to Los Angeles, and you're a mess. So what happened to that 6 months of meditation? What good did that do for you if you can't exercise it in every moment life? How does your spirituality helps you in every moment life in face of adversities and things not going your way? Where is your meditation then? You understand? Comprende? Hi, Sarah.
Hello.
Ah, nice seeing you. All right, is this your first time here?
Yes, it is.
Welcome.
Thank you.
And what country are you from?
The United States.
Oh, you're in the U.S.?
Yeah.
Where in the U.S.?
Washington State.
Washington State.
Mm-hmm.
Beautiful place. When it's nice and sunny, it's heaven, isn't it?
Yeah.
With all those islands around.
Yeah.
Yeah. Long time ago, I came and spent 3 months there, and I loved it, but it was sunny most of the time.